We got another question right down here in the front from Dame Drops.
What up,
Dame?
Hi, Dave.
Wait, I got a two-part question.
I love Dame. I'm just happy to be in his presence. I'm happy to be standing by his gangsta cookies right here with Kevin Corella from Nora Cupcakes.
Nora!
Okay, chip cookies layered with caramel, peanut butter cups, some pretzels, and then of course some extra crispy bacon for you.
Bam!
And some gold glitter, because you know, you're popping. Those are strawberry hi-hats.
Stop it. What's inside these things?
Chocolate cake baked with some fresh strawberries, a little strawberry buttercream, and then we dip the whole thing in a chocolate shell.
Fisher's Island Lemonade is a pretty amazing product. So we're a cocktail in a can. We're 9% alcohol by volume, and each can has two cocktails in it. So it's a spiked lemonade with vodka whiskey, lemon honey, and natural flavors, and it's amazing. We are the leader in the whole market of cocktail in a can.
I have not made the shot yet.
I'm feeling bad.
So just to let you know how great I am. You know what I'm saying?
Magic happening here, ladies and gentlemen.
Chicken fajitas from Main Entree Butchers.
Ooh.
Nice onions and peppers. A little bit of chipotle aioli.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Fresh scallions. MainEntree.com. We ship prime steaks, chorizo, chicken, seafood all over the country right to your door, just like you would get in the best restaurants in the country.
What are you doing, man? Come on. Come on, man. This guy's out of control. They're trying to set up. Ryan want to play around and do interviews. Or act like he's doing a job. He out of control.
I like it.
Yes. My man.
My buddy, Brandon Kyle. You guys can check him out online.
Cookbooks. Make some noise if you have a Martha Stewart cookbook. You can find her in your linen closet. That too, I guess. I mean, she's really an icon. Without further ado, let's welcome here onto the stage the one and only Martha Stewart.
So before soup gets down here, he's about ready to come here someplace, but he was working really late last night. I hope you saw him last night doing his DJ thing. He always insists that I make him a cocktail. And so I'm making a most delicious cocktail today, and it's a pomegranate vodka cocktail. What you do is you score the skin. Don't go too deep because it'll start to bleed and cry. Blood. And so just score the skin all the way around. You're gonna break this in half. Now you get your exercise for the day. Take a wooden spoon, hold this way, cut side down, and then just bash. And all the seeds start to fall out, can you see? This is the easy, bang, it's right. This is the easiest way to get the seeds out of the pot.
Great chemistry that night.
It was so fun. We all had so much fun. And then I got on a plane and I had to go, I was on vacation and I got on a plane, I don't remember anything. I was going to make the pancakes and sausage. Want to do that?
Okay.
This is a really lovely pancake recipe, buckwheat pancake.
Buckwheat?
Buckwheat. In our January, Feb issue of Martha Stewart Living Magazine. This is our issue. And a good friend of ours, John Dolan, he's this charming photographer. Look, he's really nice. He lives on this beautiful farm. There's John, and there's his wife, and he has two talented kids, over, you know, 20-year-old kids. And he and his wife entertain a lot up at this farm, and they make their own maple syrup, and they can cover the pomegranate, and they make delicious breakfast. So this is his recipe for buckwheat pancakes.
I thought that you'd get them out of the biscuit box.
No. Do you know what buckwheat is? Thing. Do you know what buckwheat is?
What is buckwheat?
Buckwheat is not wheat at all.
It ain't?
No, it's a seed of a plant that looks like a rhubarb. Do you know rhubarb?
No.
Someday you'll come in every rhubarb. Is that your phone?
I ain't got no phone.
Oh. So you want to cook the sausage?
I'm going to cook loose some fat sausage right here.
Yep, and sausage patties.
I like them. Is that Jimmy Dean? Jimmy Dean and Farmer John go a long way in the hood. You check out.
Links to this one and patties in that one.
Why not put them both in the same pot so they can get the same juices in there?
Well, we'll do that later. Oh, the colors of eggs I have. I have these dark brown ones. Look, those are called mahogany. Those are from Snoop, dark brown.
What are you doing?
Oh, yeah.
One hand, one hand. This is a beautiful look right here, I tell you that. Get that camera on the camera, you saw it. Get on the way. Get a close up of them. Get a sauce.
You want to put your ball there? Okay, well, I'm going
to do the right thing. This for me and you. Because for them to say to our show, this is a big exhibition, ain't it?
Martha, do you have a favorite Snoop song to listen to while you're cooking?
Oh, yes, because I'm always burning myself. What's that song you put to a girl that's about dropping something?
Drop it like it's hot. Let y'all get some of that aroma. I'm gonna let y'all get a little bit of that aroma. Just try to do what I'm cooking at the house, let everybody know what it is. Yeah, you smell it now.
They sense me, I burn.
So Dad's cooking now. Yeah, you smell it?
Okay, so I'm gonna make little ones.
Yeah, there you go.
That size, okay?
Right. Give me three of those.
Okay. Three?
Yeah. I'm watching my cholesterol, so you know. Three of them is enough.
That's it. You have to be fit to do what Snoop does.
Physically fit, mentally fit. Now these sausages right here, I don't know if they cook it all the way, but I know they were like getting one for it. So I can test him out.
Well, you can. Here's the fork.
Yeah, let me get that fork. That's a technique.
I just think it's good to do it anyway so they don't burst.
Yeah, right? But that's what we used to do. That's how you make sure you got to just put that little thing in there and give it a little water. And then once you see the water, you're just going to talk him back to you. Talk to me, I'll talk back. See that? Get them juices up out of there. See?
Oh, yeah.
That's a whole technique.
We're going to smell like sausage.
Martha, we have a question from the audience. They're wondering what kind of vanilla you use.
Oh, you only use the very best vanilla extract. Either Madagascar, you can use Mexican vanilla, Madagascar. I mean, it sounds sort of like the grass that you grow, right?
Right.
Electric stoves are difficult. You have electric stoves? Oh,
amazing. You see how pretty that thing is? God, look at this. Look how cute she made the meal look. I don't even want to eat it. It's so cute.
He's trying to not eat it. First. But look how beautiful.
That's what I'm saying. That is amazing.
We got another question right down here in the front from Dame Drops.
Hi, Dave.
Wait. I got a two-part question. Sorry, Martha, what was like the most difficult dish you ever had made? And then you were sitting there like, I gotta do this a few times over until I really get it right.
Brioche. Brioche.
Okay.
We're trying to copy some great French chef's brioche, which was the best brioche I had ever tasted. And we couldn't get it right. It took me and my food editors about 2 months to get it right. And we still can't make it.
Appreciate that. Now, Snoop, I know you're about to get into that. You know, me being a food critic, I know I don't want to be interrupted while I'm eating. But let me know, man. Has Martha ever created something where you had to look at her twice and be like, Martha, nah, this ain't gonna work. I don't like the flavors here. We need to do this, that, and the third to make it better, baby girl.
Yes.
She made something called a lingua. That's cow tongue. But she showed me the whole mouth before she cooked it. And I was like, I'm not really gonna go eat it. Then she prepared it, and it smelled good, but I still didn't eat it. I don't eat tongue, I got the tongue of my own. Yes. We'll talk about that later.
Awesome stuff. That'll do it for our question session. Why don't we give it up for Snoop Dogg.